Are you looking for a dedicated carbon monoxide detector that'll notify you of increased carbon monoxide levels in your home when you're away? Then you're in the right place. Hello, I'm Wanderer001, and this is my review of the xSense Link Pro Carbon Monoxide Alarm. This device was sent to me by xSense for the purposes of going over its features, so let's get into that. To start, we'll do a quick unboxing. Here we have the xSense Link Pro carbon monoxide detector itself right there. It does come pre-equipped with a battery. We also get in the box, user manual and quick start guide, warnings, as we might expect, a mounting guide, which is always helpful. Speaking of, we have our mounting hardware. Thank you for choosing, and then service information. The carbon monoxide detector itself, as you saw, does have a wall mounting option, as you might expect if it comes with hardware like that. But as you can see from little feeties here, you could hypothetically place this on a desk next to an area where you're concerned about there being a carbon monoxide buildup and get notified that way. The carbon monoxide alarm uses an electrochemical detection method that's going to give you accurate, fast detection. A lot of smoke detectors that have both carbon monoxide and smoke use that, and I've tested those. Those react very quickly. The question is, how quickly will this sound an alarm to let you know of carbon monoxide buildup? Starting at 70 parts per million, you will get a notification between 60 to 240 minutes. As it increases, 150 parts per million, you'll get notified within 10 to 50 minutes. At 400 parts per million, you will be notified within 4 to 15 minutes. So as the level of carbon monoxide increases, you will get notified much faster. Right here on the front, you can see green is power and it will flash a little green LED letting you know that it's perfectly fine. Yellow indicates that there's a fault. You'll see that there. And then red when it's alarming and making that sound. But we have to set this up in order to do that. So let's take a look at how we do that. To activate the Link Pro carbon monoxide alarm, simply turn it over. And then the included battery has a little pull tab here. If you remove the pull tab, that will initiate the alarm. You'll know you did it correctly as it calibrates itself. You can see right here, it is flashing yellow, green, and red. And we had a nice LED backlight there. We can test this simply by pressing that. You could see by bringing this closer, right up there is battery level, CO, and then parts per million. Right now you can see it is zero, so we are okay. The Link Pro carbon monoxide alarm is also compatible with the xSense application, but you will need to have a base station from xSense sold separately or as part of another product range that they have. But in order to add this to the base station, you will have the xSense app. You will open it up. You will select the plus sign in the upper right-hand corner. Come down to carbon monoxide alarms. And then here we have Pro CO2 alarm working with the particular base station that I have, or you have working with standalone Wi-Fi. We're going to select with the base station. In this case, I will first need to upgrade my base station's firmware. Now that our firmware has been updated, I can select CO alarm name, and it's just gonna say carbon monoxide. I'm gonna leave it as that is. I'm gonna leave it as such. I can select its location, or I can customize the location, which will give me a lot more options. In my case, I am going to have it in the utility room. I'm going to select next. Here we've already removed the back panel and the tab, so the batteries are in place. What we're going to do now is we are going to tap the test button twice very quickly, and then this is going to flash green. So it's now flashing green. You heard that chirp. I'm going to select next.
Ready to add a device.
The base station says it's ready to add a
device. Added.
Add a device, and that chirped very loudly. So the decibel rating on this is really loud. We're going to select finish. If we wanted to, we could add other devices. We don't have any others, so we're just going to say done. And here we go. It shows us right here the carbon monoxide detector and the current level. One of the big features that separates this from other carbon monoxide detectors that you can get is the fact that it talks to an application and allows you to be notified of issues that might arise when you're not home. There are actually a certain level of customizations that you can do for the Link Pro carbon monoxide detector, but those are all done in the xSense app. So let's take a look at it. Application for the xSense Link Pro carbon monoxide alarm. Here you can see as part of the xSense application, it's right down here, letting you know that it is online, signal strength, and battery. Also, for this one, you can see CO levels in parts per million. So if you saw something there that's anything greater than zero, you'll know you have to worry. If I tap on this, it will bring me into the device itself. Or if I select the sprocket icon right here, it will also bring me into the device. At the top, we could see large parts per million, Wi-Fi and battery. Starting at the top here, we can change the name of this device by selecting this option. We can change the location right here if we move it from where we initially set it up. Here we have device test. Now, for this device test, I will bring this over into view so that this makes a little more sense in that when I test the device, it is going to emit two sets of four quick beeps, letting you know, hey, I am working correctly. And it shows that it passed, as well as it lit up the backlight right there. Now, we do not need to test the device again, so we are going to confirm and come back to our main screen. After our device test, we have base station alarms. If you set this up to the base station, you have a sliding scale for how loud you like the sounds to be, as well as different tones. So if you have different xSense devices, you can set up different tones. In my case, that's tone one, tone two, and tone three. Here we have our CO alarm history. Ideally, this should be empty because you're not having CO in your home. But if you did have an instance, you would get notification. You would see a history of it here. Event history, likewise, will show you a history of things that have happened. In my case, you could see right here, I ran a test. So it's letting you know, at this time, a test was run. If I come up to the calendar icon in the upper right-hand corner, it'll also show me a little dot on the calendar, letting me know that there was an event history that I can go back and look through. We have our notifications. Here you can change what gets pushed to your smartphone. Here, I want to be notified about CO alarm precaution. I want to know about CO alarm triggering. I don't care when the alarm ends or when the device is silenced or if a device test is ran. If I did have this on when I ran that test, I would have gotten a notification. Device malfunction, want to know about that. And I want to know about low battery. Here we have offline notification. This is if your device, for whatever reason, loses connection with the base station or goes offline, you'll be notified. Here we have our device information. Not important to go through that, but that's where that information is housed. And then help and feedback. Selecting that, you can contact, give feedback, or troubleshoot your individual device. And that is everything that we can do for the xSense Link Pro carbon monoxide alarm utilizing the xSense application. If you haven't gotten the idea, I really like the xSense Link Pro carbon monoxide detector. Depending on where you live, you might actually be required to have a carbon monoxide detector on each level of your home. And while you might have a smoke detector carbon monoxide combination unit, sometimes you are not placing that close enough to where carbon monoxide might be building up because you have it placed more for smoke. Having a device like this where you could place it closer to problem areas is very useful. The fact that it has an application which can notify you while you're away if a problem arises, and the fact that depending on if you have other xSense units, they can all intercommunicate with each other. And if there happens to be an issue in one area of your house, you could be notified at another because this will link up to the other device and let you know. The fact that you can be notified while you're not home with this is a game changer. Because whether it's your concern about pets that you left home, or perhaps you have this in the home of an aging parent that you want to keep track of, that level of security and peace of mind is priceless. Because of that, I do strongly recommend checking out the xSense Link Pro carbon monoxide detector if you're looking for a standalone carbon monoxide unit that also can notify you if there's a problem while you're away from home. If you appreciate the time and effort that goes into making a video like this, make sure to hit that like button to help other people find the video as well. If you like what I'm doing here and want to be notified of my next review, hit that subscribe button. Wondering what other products xSense has? On screen now, you could see several other product reviews that I've done for xSense products in case you're considering outfitting your entire home with more safety hardware.